Hi, it's Boronian. Today I want to show you another replay. This time not a defeat but a win. But a win which had no turn one play. So at some point it looked very dire during the match. So let's watch it. So it's a Xerox Obelisk deck against a Kaz deck. And like I said, there was no turn one play. You see, two Whisper of the Sands. Land, you don't need it in the beginning. Cut back and yeah, nothing. So let's see what, but now the Obelisk. Let's see what Kaz can play. At least a turn two play is there now. Because before there wasn't. Well, replace the cards. Yeah. So, it seems this Kaz plays a Lilith deck. I mean, Wraithling Swarm and Gloom Chaser are Lilith minions. But okay, seems a little bit weird, but that's fine. This is very very threatening position, especially if Kaz has Deathfly Crescendo in hand, or Soul Grimoire, or Shadow Watcher. Then this could create a really big minion. Deathfly Crescendo could make a lot of damage. I mean, Deathfly Crescendo on this one, yeah, could be brutal. So the question is, does Xerox go forward, clean Gloom Chaser and Tiger into its first wish to clean another of the Wraithlings, which offers a lot of targets for Deathwatch? So it's probably not the best idea, especially because there's Scorns in the hand on 4 mana. So maybe retreating back to the war so only that Wraithling can attack, and playing this Scorn is the best option to have this all cleared. Except the Gloom Chaser. So play defensively and wait for the time to strike back. And probably play the Obelisk now. Here or here, so it can't get attacked by the Gloom Chaser, only by this Wraithling. And the buff isn't that bad because Xerox needs more cards than only the what he has in hand. And who knows, this one hit point could become good. Yeah, this is really bad. Crimson Oculus, it's a card you don't see that often. It gets +1/+1 every time the opponent summons a minion, and Dervishes sounds as summoning, counts as summoning. So this can get really, really big. It's dangerous. But right now, I mean, it's very aggressively positioned, so General plus Dervish would clean it. Unfortunately, hit the lure and put it away. Which makes it even worse. Because now, it was the only bad spawn. There were two good spawns, where at least the Gloom Shader could have get cleaned. Which would have been really good. Because it survives this Scorn, but well, Xerox got a bad one here. But this is really bad because every turn Crimson Oculus gets +1/+1, and this card does nothing, this minion does nothing back here. This is really bad, except you have Reassemble, where we can reposition this obelisk. But yeah, this is the question: how do you position the Blissings Gone? Because Silix alone, I mean, let's first replace. So there's the resemble where you could bring the obelisk back into play here. But you can't deal with Crimson Oculus. Even a Falcius would buff it, and so you Silix can kill it with 4 damage. So this one will survive, unfortunately, but all these others are in the way and have to get removed. The only way to remove the Oculus is with Tiger. So Tiger plus General would kill Oculus. But then there's the same problem again, that all these Wraithlings, probably positioning would be best here for the General, because then the Gloom Chaser can't attack, but all these others are here. And Silix would have taken already 4 damage. So kind of difficult situation. Easy would maybe be to kill it with Entropy Decay, then with Tiger, even better, because then Silix wouldn't take any damage. But still, no minion on board. That's a bad play. So what Silix did, we will see in a moment. Go down in the corner and put Blissings Gone here to block the way. So what can happen now? Crimson Oculus could trade with Scorn, totally fine, great play for us. Or he could try to go attack with Gloom Chaser, move the Crimson Oculus to make room for the Cass, so she can attack too and clean it. But at least it has saved us one turn, because Crimson Oculus can't attack us, except Cass has an answer. Blood Tide Priestess, she's called now. That's very interesting. Especially positioning here is very, not great. And the moving is weird to move here. So, that should have been here. Or actually here. Even better here, yes. So that it only needs 1, 2, 3, 4 Wraithlings to surround. It's bad. So if you play a Blood Tide Priestess, you always try to play it in a way that it gets surrounded the same turn, especially against Vitruvian, because they don't have an answer except Blood of Air to kill a surrounded Blood Tide Priestess. This play here, it's in attack range of Silix, and he has another Blissling's Gone in hand, so next turn Blood Tide Priestess is dead. But actually, it's one of the strongest card you can find in Abyssian decks. So this position was too aggressive and too careless. Should be back here, so Silix can't reach it. In the same thought, Cass has to know that Silix often has, or Vitruvian has, Entropy Decay. So even that could be used here. And this is also very weird that Cass decided not to attack Blissings Gone and kill it. But okay. Actually, Cass should have used Abyss's Guard, a BBS, on its own Wraithling to maybe get a spawn here. which would have made positioning a little bit different, difficult. In the end, it doesn't matter, I think. But still, it's two BBS dead. I don't know. Doesn't make a lot of sense because till that dies, it takes forever. And then she would have had a creep tile here, and creep to have a creep tile is never bad. Because for episode Juggernaut, or just for, yeah, a minion who has to move on there and get the damage. So, yeah. And now this can get cleaned up both together with one scorn. So, but the order of things is important. This has that, so if you order it wrong, in a wrong way, the Crimson Oculus doesn't die. So this is not, can't be played first. First, this Scorn has to attack the Crimson Oculus to get it down to one half, because this is an open gambit works before the minion hits the board. So first it gets one damage, then it procs the +1/+1, but then it's already dead. Yeah, and also if that one dies first, and then the 1/1 who spawns from the Bloodtide Priestess get killed. So that's also important that Zirx moves first, because if that dies before, could be that the Rifting spawns here, and then then could move here. Yeah, still possible. But yeah, the ordering of the cards is really important sometimes. Interesting. So it's good to know, or it's important to know, that as soon as Bloodtide Priestess dies, she doesn't spawn any other Wraithling, because that one died and that one died. So she, but because she died too, no Wraithling spawned. Yeah, it was a good turn, and now the whole game turned. It was a turning point. Of course, this turning point was only possible because Cass did a lot of mistakes in the way she played the cards here. But still, it's always important to keep calm and, yeah, to think, how can I get out of a situation like that where I have no turn one play, I'm more or less in the corner, surrounded by enemies. There's sometimes a way, and yeah, you have to wait for mistakes your opponent does, but still, that's always possible. Let's see what Cass is doing. So that was weird too, and not a great, yeah, I don't know what she has in hand, but so Shadow Nova itself is not that great a card, because it costs too much and doesn't do enough. It's 4 mana, it's almost a whole turn, and yeah, we got a damage, but the minions still live. And remember, if the turn before, Cass used the BBS without any reason on this obelisk, and now then she didn't have it last turn to kill the Scorn. Of course, that would have meant she couldn't have played the Healing Mystic, but to kill Scorn is more important, I think. And also interesting that she chose to attack and not to retreat, what would have been probably better tactic. Because The last turn she didn't attack the other score and could have killed it, but she didn't. She chose not to do. And now she attacked but still alive. Yeah. So there's several options here. First off, it's a good idea to get this obelisk back in play here with a reassemble and also draw a card. But it's important to play something before, because you shouldn't forget that reassemble gets you two cards, the obelisk you get back and the draw a card. So if it's used on a full hand like that, you get only the obelisk and you will mill a card. So first play another card. I think Entropic Decay to have in the hand is always good. When you see a card like Shadow Nova, you always have to expect Abyssal Juggernauts too. So that's good to have against that. So this costs 2 mana, then there's 4 left, another 2, and probably Sion's Second Wish to go face. See what's happening. Okay, that's the mistake I told you. That this mill the card. A tune caster too. Which would have been good. Because then this dervish could have been buffed and survived could have killed the healing mystic on his own and survived the attack too. Moving off the creep tile is important. And then there's the question of it's pretty obvious to play these two obelisk, where to position them. Because now it's a good idea to try to keep Cass in that corner. Close to the obelisk where every turn dervish is spawn, etc. So probably one here and maybe one here or maybe up, depends. That wouldn't be bad maybe. But on the other hand, if it's... That's fine too, because the advantage of positioning obelisk at the wall is that you can control better the spawns. Because if it's like this one's free in the middle of the battlefield, you can spawn everywhere, and that's sometimes really bad. Here the wall, you have a better control of it. You know it can only get here, and you can better plan with that. So that's the reason why obelisks are often positioned at the wall. No replays in that turn. A lot of answers though. Maybe we should have replaced one answer. Because these are only reactive cards. Tiger, Entropy Decay. Okay, Sensor Reader generates some tempo because it's a minion, removes, gets another frozen minion back to their hand. And that can be used, by the way, on own minion too, on their own minions too. So, and then it has these, creates this Exhuming Sand, which can proc, which will summon a dervish, 2/2 dervish, if you summon a minion from the hand. So if you use that on a dervish, example, and summon a dervish back from your hand, you get a 2/2 and the dervish has rush 2, so yeah, that's sometimes not only to use it on hostile or your opponent's minions, but on your own too. Just a naked Shadow Watcher. Cleaned it. Probably first wish it. Yeah. And yeah, resemble on that one and put it closer. This is kind of a greedy play. The boxer completely in. And it gets punished too. Yeah. In a moment. Hammer shot. Because the Cas has Necrotic Sphere. It totally punished that play. And tries to ward her off. But it doesn't matter, of course, because yeah, Cyrix has two tigers in hand and enough on stuff on board that to clean out, and the orb fireblaze obelisk too. So yeah, several ways to kill her, but still, it was kind of greedy play to reassemble that one, to put it up there to really box it in. Didn't consider something like Necrotic Fear here. And yeah. So, to conclude what we learned from that match. Don't give up. Even with all the turn one play, if your opponent makes mistakes, and especially in bronze and silver, these are very common, but even also in gold, you can get back. Stay calm and think about your plays, think about maybe something, think about the next turn, or maybe even two turns in the future, but that's really difficult, but at least the next plan, the next turn you can plan out. Think about what answers you have and how you can get back from that board of state. Also consider what's in your deck. What answers do you have for that situation? For what card you have to dig in your deck? And maybe your opponent is doing the mistakes. Or maybe he's playing perfectly and you have no chance, but you never know. So I hope that was helpful. And see you around.